So I promised myself, I'm going to make sure when I get out of school, I'm going to do everything I can do to make sure a child get educated who comes through me. And I did, and I'm, excuse me, I'm glad to say that I know that there are a lot of children who I taught went to college. Some of them are doctors, lawyers, and teachers. I know that they went to college because when my two children were going to school, they were right across the street from me. And when I went over to pick them up, it was a mob. Here's my teacher, fine. But I just said, fine. But it was a joy that they were telling me, I have a football scholarship. I'm going to go to this college. I'm going to go to that college. I know your son. I know your daughter. And it made me feel good that they were going. I know one reason that the black male needs more money to take care of his family. There isn't much money as a beginner, as a teacher. There's very little money.
Did you go to school with white kids?
No.
Okay, so you saw no effect.
No, I saw no effect. But I had two sisters who, years later, when they had some type of zoning kind of thing, and they had to send the black kids, but I was out and married then. I was living somewhere else, and they definitely didn't like it because of, I'm telling you what they told me. They had, every morning, they could not go into their classroom. They had to go to the principal's office, and he will talk to them about, now, you know, you're used to eating chitlin and pig feet and pork chop, that type of thing. They received that lectures like that every day, and then they set off in another room to get their lesson. It's the same as history of black people in general. Our history is not told. It is not being presented correctly. I'll give you an example. In Vallejo, there was a white teacher teaching her class, and there was one of my friends. Look, she had a child in the class, and she was teaching that slavery was not bad at all. The slave complained a lot, but they enjoyed it. And you know, that's a lie right out of Pit of Hell. Slaves did not like eating off the ground. They did not like being beaten. Being raped, killed. Tell me what is likable about that? So they lie about our history. And I noticed not only about the black history, if you notice that the Indian history is not written correctly. You read it and you understand, you know, if you know any Indians, you know that their history is almost a lost cause, like ours. I'm grateful that a lot of our history was kept. It can be done. It may be a slow process. The way we do the voting system, we have those meetings, like town meetings. And what we're going to have to start doing is to start having meetings. There are a lot of black men out here who would love to teach. And there are a lot of black men out there who are very good at it. And because I know there are a couple of in my church who are always talking about the kids need to do this. The kids need to know this. And you know, we had a very good tutoring program for black men. But once they get away, once they leave the seventh grade all the other jobs begin to look good. And I, not only for the black male, but for the black women. My daughter told me when she graduated from University of Notre Dame, she looked at the salary scale. And she said, do they want me to teach